Deadly crash outside a local movie theater. A drunk driver hits two police cruisers and then a tree. Shannon Perrine is live. And Shannon, in fact, more people could have been killed here, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's a really dangerous situation, Wendy. We're live at police headquarters because despite the fact that the suspect died immediately in this crash, police are not done with this. They want to know more. They want to know what led to this whole incident. And police are also grateful that only one family is planning a funeral tonight. Green paint on the pavement shows the path. Police say their dash camera video shows 32-year-old Benjamin Biebler out of control.
That shows the subject vehicle on the wrong side of the roadway, traveling head-on into the police unit.
The whole thing started at a bar across McKnight Road. This was never a police chase because police never had a chance to really go after this guy. Less than a half a mile later, he ended up here in this parking lot where he smashed right into this tree and died.
We actually thought we were going to get hit with the car because it was coming straight towards us.
Moviegoers headed to the theater here ran to dodge the car.
Here, the car coming through the parking lot on the bumps, it was bottoming out. It was, how 80 mile an hour through a parking lot with bumps is going to, go up and down and make some noise.
Police are mystified why Benjamin Biebler did what he did. In the bar parking lot, police say Biebler was in the driver's seat. The car door was open and an officer was trying to get him out. Biebler almost hit that officer when he backed up and took off.
It was very simple. Comply with the request of the police and bad things don't happen.
He says it could have ended with more than one death.
The general public certainly was in danger. We have them traveling at a high rate of speed through a very busy intersection on a very busy roadway. And clearly the officers were at peril.
The bar manager told police they called a cab for Biebler. He refused to take it. Seconds later, his life was over. Now, police still don't know why the driver refused to comply with their commands, and they may never get the answer to that question. Reporting live, I'm Shannon Perrine, Channel 4 Action News.